Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pi My Life Up. In this video, we'll be showing you how to set up the Minecraft Java Edition server on Ubuntu. This will work for both the desktop and server flavors of Ubuntu. Additionally, it will actually work on any Debian-based operating system, as there isn't anything we're doing in this tutorial that is specific to Ubuntu. Before we get started, we highly recommend that you set up a static IP address for your server. If you are hosting this with a server provider, you will likely already have a static IP address provided to you. If you are hosting the Minecraft Java Edition server from your home, you'll want to enable a static IP address through DHCP reservation on your router. If you don't have access to your router, we have included guides below on how you can work around this. Once you are ready to proceed, open up the terminal on your Ubuntu device or connect to it over SSH. Once connected, update the package list by typing in sudo apt update. Once update completes, upgrade any out-of-date packages by typing in sudo apt upgrade-y and pressing enter. We can now move on and install all of the packages that we require to run the Minecraft Java Edition server on our Ubuntu device. Install these packages by typing in sudo apt install openjdk-21-jre-headless /kel-wget-grep-y. The first package we install from this list is the one that provides us access to the Java runtime. This is required to get the Minecraft server up and running. The other three packages are what we'll be using to ensure that we download the latest release of the Minecraft Java Edition server. With all the packages we need now installed to Ubuntu, we can move on to creating a user that we'll use to run the server. Create a user called mcserver by typing in sudo space userad space hyphen m space mcserver. To help reduce the chances of running into permission issues every time you want to deal with this server, add your current user to the mcserver group by typing in sudo space usermod space hyphen a capital G space mcserver space $user. To ensure these changes are read in by the rest of your system, reboot Ubuntu by typing in sudo space reboot and pressing enter. Once Ubuntu finishes restarting, we can proceed with setting up the Minecraft Java Edition server. Our next step is to create a directory where we will store the Minecraft server itself. We can do this by typing in sudo space mkdir space hyphen p space /home/mcserver/minecraft. Once the directory is created, change into it by typing in cd space /home/mcserver/minecraft. We can now use a bit of curl and grep magic to grab the latest download link for the Minecraft Java Edition server. To grab this latest release, type in download underlying URL, all in uppercase, followed by the equal sign, dollar sign symbol, and then open bracket, kel, space, hyphen, capital H, space, double quote, accept, hyphen, encoding, colon, space, identity, double quote, space, hyphen, capital H, space, double quote, accept, hyphen, language, colon, space, en, double quote, space, hyphen S, space, hyphen, capital L, space, hyphen, capital A, space, double quote, Mozilla, /4.0, space, open bracket, compatible, semicolon, space, MSIE, space, 6.0, semicolon, space, Windows, space, NT, space, 5.1, semicolon, space, Java, hyphen, updater, all in uppercase, then close bracket, then double quote, space https://www.minecraft.net/en-us/download/server /pipe symbol/grep/hyphen o/\https.*\jar\ What this super long command does is grab the download page for Minecraft, then passes it to grep, which searches it for a specific string that contains the download URL. The command looks so long because we have to specify certain headers, otherwise our connection request is blocked by the Minecraft server. We can verify that we got the correct URL by typing in echo space dollar sign symbol download underline URL. This should show you a long URL that ends with server.jar. If the URL looks correct, we can then proceed to use this URL to download the latest release of the Minecraft Java Edition server to Ubuntu. To do this, we'll be using the wget command that we installed earlier. Type in sudo space wget space hyphen capital U space double quote Mozilla slash 4.0 space open bracket compatible semicolon space MSIE space 6.0 semicolon space Windows NT space 5.1 semicolon space Java hyphen updater all in uppercase close bracket double quote space dollar sign symbol download underline URL all in uppercase space hyphen capital O space dot slash server dot jar. With the Java Edition server now saved to your Ubuntu system, we will now want to run it so that it will generate all the necessary files. To run this jar file we just downloaded, type in sudo space java space hyphen capital XMS 1024 capital M space hyphen XMX 2048 capital M space hyphen jar space dot slash server dot jar space no GUI and then press enter. We'll explain this command a bit better later on in the guide, but for now we just need to get the Java server to generate some files including the end user license agreement file. You should see a message on your screen stating that you need to agree to the Minecraft EULA before the server will run. To agree to this license agreement, we must edit the file it just generated by typing in sudo space nano space eula.txt and pressing enter. Now if you agree to the Minecraft end user license agreement, change false to true all in uppercase. Once you're done, save and quit by pressing Ctrl plus X and then Y and then enter. Our next step is to write a start and stop script that will manage our Minecraft Java Edition server on Ubuntu. Begin writing the start script by typing in sudo space nano space dot slash start online server dot sh. Start off this file by typing in hashtag exclamation mark slash user slash bin slash env space bash. This line just helps the terminal to understand how it should run this file. Next, type in the line that will start the server itself by typing in slash user slash bin slash screen space hyphen d m capital S space MC Java space slash user slash bin slash Java space hyphen XMS followed by the minimum amount of memory in megabytes that you want the server to use. For our short example, we'll be setting the minimum amount of RAM to 1 gigabyte or 1024 megabyte. Next, we set the maximum amount of memory that this server can use by typing in hyphen capital XMX followed by the maximum amount of RAM that your Minecraft Java Edition server can consume, followed by a capital M. For our example, we are limiting our server to using 2 gigabytes of RAM or 2048 megabytes. Next, we tell Java that we are executing a jar file by typing in hyphen jar space slash home slash MC server slash Minecraft slash server dot jar. We then tell the server that we don't want a GUI by typing in space no GUI. Now on a new line, type slash user slash bin slash screen space hyphen R capital D space MC Java space hyphen capital X space multi-user space on. Then on another line, type in slash user slash bin slash screen space hyphen R capital D space MC Java space hyphen X space ACL add space root. What these two lines essentially are doing is allowing us to access the MC Java screen that we are creating with the root user. We are setting up this screen so we can continue to easily access the Minecraft server's command line interface and also so we can safely stop it by setting the stop command through the screen. You can now save and quit by pressing Ctrl plus X, then Y, and then enter. Now give this file execute privileges by typing in sudo space chmod space plus x space dot slash /start_server.sh. Now we can begin writing the script that will stop the server by typing in sudo space nano space dot slash stop underline server dot sh. Start this file just like the last one by typing in hashtag exclamation mark slash user slash bin slash env space bash. Then on a new line, type in slash user slash bin slash screen space hyphen capital R D space MC Java space hyphen capital X space stuff space double quote stop space backward slash R double quote. All this does is send the stop message to the Minecraft Java Edition server so that it will safely save and shut down. All you need to do now is save and quit by pressing Ctrl plus X, then Y, and then Enter. This script will also need execute privileges, so type in sudo space chmod space plus X space dot slash stop underline server dot sh. Now, to prevent running into permission issues later, ensure the files we just created are all owned by the MC server user by typing in sudo space chown space hyphen capital R space MC server colon MC server space slash home slash MC server. We can now start writing the service file that will manage our Minecraft Java Edition server on Ubuntu by typing in sudo space nano space slash etc slash systemd slash system slash minecraft server dot service. Within this file, start by defining a new unit, then set the description to Minecraft space server. Then we want to set the wants to equal network hyphen online.target, and we'll also set the after to the same thing. These will ensure that the Minecraft server is only started after the network stack is available. After this, define the service section and then to set the type to forking, and then we'll want to set the user to MC server and the group also to MC server. We will now want to set the working directory to the directory where our Minecraft server is located, which will be slash home slash MC server slash Minecraft. Next, set this command that will start the server by typing exec start equals slash user slash bin slash bash space slash home slash MC server slash Minecraft slash start underline server dot sh. Now we'll do the same with our exec stop line, but this time we'll reference the stop underline server.sh script that we wrote. Essentially, what we did with these two lines is set it so the start underline server.sh script will be executed when the server starts, and then the stop script will be executed when the service is stopped. Now, set restart to equal always to ensure the server is restarted whenever an error occurs. Then set timeout starts sec to 600 to give the service more time when starting up. Now we set the install section where we set wanted by to multi-user.target. Once done, save and quit by pressing Ctrl plus X, then Y, and then Enter. We will now want to enable this new server so that the Minecraft Java Edition server is started whenever Ubuntu does. To this, type in sudo space systemctl space enable space Minecraft server and then press enter. Once enabled, we can start the server itself by typing in sudo space systemctl space start space Minecraft server. You should now have the Minecraft Java Edition server up and running on your system. You can verify that it is running by typing in sudo space systemctl space status space Minecraft server. If everything is working properly, you will see that the status is marked as active running. Now press Q to quit out of this tool, and then use the command hostname space hyphen capital I to get the IP address of your Ubuntu machine. In our case, you can see our IP is 192.168.0.8. Now let's verify that everything is working by opening up the Java Edition client, clicking the multiplayer option, then clicking direct connection and typing in the IP address for your Minecraft server, and then clicking the join server button. You can see that we have now successfully set up a Minecraft Java Edition server on Ubuntu. If you want access outside of a home network, you will need to port forward port 25565, or alternatively use a service like Tailscale. We've included a guide on setting up Tailscale in the description below. Now back on the terminal, let us show you how you can access the screen that we set up earlier so that you can interact directly with the Minecraft Java Edition server. Restore this screen by typing in sudo space screen space hyphen r space mcserver slash mcjava and then pressing enter. You now have full access to the Minecraft server's command line interface, and you can also see all the logs that have been appearing within this interface. For this example, let's give our user defdroid op privileges by typing in op space defdroid and pressing enter. Here you can see that we were successfully made a server operator. Now that we are done with the command line interface, we will want to detach it and put it back into its original state by pressing Ctrl plus A and then Ctrl plus D. It is super important to move it back to its detached state so that our stop script will be able to send the stop message when shutting the server down. At this point, you have successfully gotten a Minecraft Java Edition server up and running on your Ubuntu or Linux-based operating system. If you have found this guide to be helpful, please be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.